Natasha, one of the co-organizers. So let me talk a little bit about Design Bootcamp Asia. Oops. So we are a community embracing design, and in this connected network, we hope to find and recognize hidden gems. So especially in Asia, actually. Okay? And we celebrate and appreciate diversity. We hope to nurture. And our core value, being a designer, is to be humble, to be open, and hopefully, whatever we're doing now, we're making a social impact. So today, our 14th meetup, our topic is on design that scales. We have three product designers, Desmond from ReferralCandy, Simin and Jill from Zendesk, who's a proud sponsor, and they are really supporting us with the venue host and all the food, you know, which you are enjoying just now. So I'll let them introduce themselves and share their journey on how they explore design that scales. So let's start off with Desmond.
Thank you, Natasha. Okay, let me operate this. I can do it. Yes. Okay. Oh, wait. Okay. Thanks for your patience. Good evening, everyone. I'm Desmond. I'm from ReferralCandy. So today I'm going to be presenting about designing for word of mouth. Oh, wait, this is not full screen. So I'm Desmond. I'm not only a product designer at ReferralCandy, I'm also co-founder at Statement.sg, which we'll find out later what it is. And today is my birthday. So actually, this is actually just my birthday party. You guys will see my slideshow of me growing up and all that. Okay, just kidding. So I don't actually have a dog. That's just a picture of me smiling genuinely. So that was nice. Good for Tinder. for the friend to want to visit your online store, the product's value proposition has to be very clear. They need to be attracted to the product. And lastly, for them to check out, maybe they will have to be convinced by multiple sources. Because, for example, if one person tells you brand X has very good air freshener, then you'll be like, okay, sure. But if suddenly your mom, your grandma, your friend, your wife, or anything tells you, oh, brand X has really good air freshener, you'll be like, huh, everyone around me is talking about brand X air freshener. I should check it out. So multiple sources really helps, because sometimes your brand is not the only brand trying to get people to refer. They get bombarded by many other brands as well. So seasonal needs. So for example, if I recommend, what's a brand to recommend? Say, toothpaste. I recommend a toothpaste to you right now. But you still have a full tube of toothpaste. You are not going to buy the toothpaste immediately. Maybe you'll wait till your toothpaste is depleted. Then you buy it. So certain things are really seasonal. In fact, for example, flowers. I can refer you to a flower, like a florist, but maybe you don't need to buy a flower now. You need to wait till Christmas or Valentine's Day or your anniversary. So certain things really take time, and this affects the checkout rate. Like, when you don't get checkout immediately, it doesn't mean that it's not successful. Certain things take time, and these things affect them. And finally, when people get referred, the advocate is happy as well. So it makes the advocate feel good. Like, if you need to get a really good... running out of examples. Say if you want a really good smartphone, I recommend iPhone to you, and you really benefited from it, me as an advocate, when I see it, I also feel good. And that may trigger me to refer more, to let more people know about this product. And friend closeness also matters as well. You're not going to run up to a stranger and tell them to buy spectacles. Most people actually prefer to refer to their close friends. They don't want to seem pushy. So yeah, these are some of the things that you can think about when triggering referrals in referral program. The challenge for referral candy is really that every industry really works differently. Some products have I should have taken examples from this. But anyway, some products have a longer cycle. Like, how often do you buy a wheel? You don't buy it every day. But for clothes, you can buy it every other week or every other month. Same goes for handbags and shoes. Fine art, maybe you don't buy it that often unless you collect it or luggage. So different industry really has different patterns, and we are constantly trying to upgrade our product to be very intelligent about it so that we can give more personalized tips. So yeah, so to sum it up, to run a referral program, there are certain things you can think of, say incentives. How do you make it more attractive? Like, sometimes two-sided incentive is better. Two-sided meaning, if I refer a friend, I get benefit. The friend gets benefit. And for incentive, maybe if the repeat purchase is not very likely, you can offer to reward cash. But if they are likely to refer to make a repeat purchase, you can offer discount. Stuff like that. So, yeah, message can be more persuasive. One example could be, like, scarcity. Like, make sure, maybe you tell them discount expires in 7 days. To make people more aware, actually, right now I'm a Circles Life user, if anyone wants to switch to Circles Life, I have a referral code. But anyway, you can make people more aware by sending a weekly email. So the Circles Life does that for me. Every week they send me an email about the leadership board, who referred the most friends. It makes it like a competition. And other triggers, so flower is an example. Like, other triggers could be people's anniversary, but you don't really know your friend's anniversary with their wife or husband. So that's a bit hard. But yeah, these are things that you can take note of. So that's mostly it for my slide today. To design for word of mouth, there are many, many ways. Today I'm just covering 5 because it's not a master class. But I hope that you get some new understanding and something that you can apply to your design work or your marketing work. And if you find this hard to remember, if there's only one thing to take away, is that it's my birthday. No, just kidding. Make a product that really wows yourself. Make sure that it really blows your mind. Yes. So solve a meaningful problem that you solve it so well that you can't help but tell everyone about it. And that's it. Thank you. Any questions? You can ask me personal questions as well.
the question.
Oh, you mean the Statement t-shirt? Right. So for Statement, actually, the examples I showed today are really local. We have some t-shirt designs that are more universal. We have a t-shirt that says professional procrastinator. Or what are the others? So there's the danger high voltage sign that plays well with others. So we've got some